Good evening and welcome back to BioBlitz 2013 here in the amazing landscape of Glendalough, high up in the Wicklow Mountains. It's been a hectic 24 hours. I can tell you that teams have been racing right across the country trying to record as many wildlife species as they possibly can, and the results are in. Yes, what another beautiful evening it is here at Glendalough. We have been blessed with the weather, but it all started here on Friday afternoon at 5 o'clock, a unique event which brought together some of Ireland's best wildlife experts, a great culmination to RTE Goes Wild Month on television, on radio and online.
And what followed was an intensive 24-hour challenge as four teams combed their sights across the country in an effort to find every plant, fungus, fish, mammal and lichen they could. And all this in the quest to become this year's BioBlitz champions.
And in fairness, it has to be said, the locations were absolutely stunning. There was one team based right here in the splendour of the Wicklow Mountains National Park, another in the beautiful Lochee, County Roscommon, and for the first time ever, Coldbrook Estate in County Fermanagh was surveyed. But now let's have a look at what happened when the BioBlitzers hit up the Burren in County Clare.
Well, it's going to be very interesting to see at the end of the 24-hour period how we get on. The odds-on favourite is the Burren National Park because it's well-renowned for being a fantastically important nature conservation site. It's got a very, very strong team of experts.
3, 2, 1.
The Burren is a really, really interesting place, and the main reason for that is it's the actual limestone rock itself. This rock is made up of billions and billions of skeletons from marine animals. For the walk today, we had a variety of type of people. We had some young kids as well, so it was really great to be able to show them all the plant species that occur on the actual limestone pavement itself and deep in the grikes, and also on some of these shallow grasslands.
Really good now, everybody's really excited today, you know. We're hoping for a busy morning and maybe then not too much coming in the afternoon so we're not under pressure.
I'm Brian Nelson, I work for National Parks and Wildlife Service. I work on invertebrates and insects. There's lots of spiders, bugs, beetles, flies, bees, ants. Everything really occurs here in the Burren. We're just going to hoover up some insects and then we're going to take them and see if we can identify them.
Slowworms are a lizard. They look like a snake because they have actually no legs, but they're actually a lizard. And they're only found in Ireland in the Burren, which is where we are today. So we're here looking for them. And it's not a good day for it because it's really too cold. They were probably accidentally introduced here in the 50s or 60s, I suspect. They're kept as pets in the UK, where they're reasonably common. But they haven't really spread very much here, which is interesting.
Look, look, look. Now, this is the sort of place they'd hide.
Okay, fingers crossed. No slow worms, though. It's not a slow worm, but it's another lizard, like a slow worm.
It's a lizard with legs.
This time it's legs, yeah.
Electrofishing, it's a surveying technique that we use in inland fisheries Ireland. Fish are actually attracted to the net, and then they're kind of slightly anesthetized, if you like, by the current, so that we can lift them up and put them into a bucket. And the minute you put them in the bucket, they're swimming around, you know. We found eels, and we found stickleback and pike. But we're looking also at the food of the fish, the invertebrates.
There's a little water spider we found earlier on, a very rare
type of water spider. What's it called, Rory, again?
A water spider.
When you look at the whole ecosystem that's here with the trees and even the grasses, the wildlife growing and living in this area, I think this burn has a great chance of winning.
So that was the burn. So tell me about the burn's results, Sinead. What do you know?
I know everything, Derek, right? So they recorded the most amount of birds out of all the four sites.
Oh, very good.
78 species were recorded, as well as the merlin, which was a very interesting find. Apart from just recording the most number of birds, they actually recorded the highest number of butterflies and moths in all four sites as well. And as well as that, bees-wise, Jimmy Marin is going to be delighted with himself, the young fella who featured on the show the other night, because he actually recorded one of two endangered bees that were actually recorded on the night or the day or whenever he recorded it, and it was the shrill carder bee. So there you go.
Not the shrill carder.
Yes, the shrill carder.
I've been looking for that all my life. Never heard of it, I have to be honest.
Like,
to say.
No, me either.
But what I noticed that they didn't find the slow worm, and when I was talking to Jerry Murphy here the other evening, he was talking about it being a little bit cold, and I said that means it mightn't be good for the slow worm because the slow worm really does need the heat, even though it gets a certain amount of heat from the rocks down there on the burn. Obviously, not enough of it didn't come out. In fact, in parts of the burn, you'll see corrugated iron, which is left out there as habitat for the slow worm.
Yeah, I saw them on the day,
actually. Wonder, and if you lift it up, it's a slow worm. People think it's a snake, but it's actually a slow worm. But they didn't find them, so hard luck, you didn't get any slow worms.
No legless lizards, eh?
No legless lizards.
And what was interesting, they mentioned that the turlocks, which are these sort of seasonal lakes, they are still full of water right now. They should be well empty, and they should be wildflower meadows. So the poor old botanist came walking along, thinking, you know, this is going to be great. And They should have brought their scuba gear because there were no wildflowers there. So hence they would have been affected by that a little bit.
They must have thought they were in Killarney with all those lakes.
Maybe.
They're having a bit of bad luck with the slow worm and obviously the turlocks and the water and stuff. But
let's move on to location number two, Colebrook Estate in County Fermanagh. How do they do?
Colebrook Estate is quite special because it's a private estate, so it's not somewhere people can get on a regular basis.
Thank you very much indeed for coming. You should all recognise one reason why you're here. You're here to win.
3, 2, 1, go!
We've been out looking for all types of living things, plants, animals, fungi, lichen, and we've had all the beardy weirdies in the country come down, really, all the recorders who are out there. But we also wanted to encourage people who are interested, who are beginners, who are young and curious and just want to know a wee bit more about what's going on in the world.
There's so many habitats here, you know, we're going to find loads of different species of fungi. For example, we've got the St. George's mushroom here that we've come across, and this is actually one of the good edible ones, so it'll be nice to find a few more of these. So.
We've got things that eat the leaves, things that are right at the top on little tiny branches. So there's lots of different homes in that tree for all sorts of different creatures. Oh, we've got a bat!
That was the Leislers. If it just went past there, 27-28, everybody put your bat detectors to that.
There he goes! Oh, they're all coming out of the tree. Look, the crack in the tree, the crack in the tree.
It's great to be here for the dawn chorus at Colebrook this morning. And the reason why birds are singing so early in the morning, they can't hunt at this time in the morning because there's no insects or invertebrates ready. So the best thing they can do, the best use of their time, is just to sing. The air is so still, which is fabulous because the sound travels up to 20 times longer and higher than it would do at midday, which is incredible. So birds like the song thrush, blackbird, robin, they're the ones we've been hearing this morning. They get up with their big eyes and start singing to hold their territories and also to look for a mate.
It is beautiful, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Where
we've only got an hour to go now, so we're going to try and get some of the more freshwater things out of this pond here.
What is he hoping to find? Snails and larvae of things off the underneath of plants and that sort of thing.
That's a mini giant water beetle, isn't it?
Lots of little snails. Okay, should we take this one back?
I'll just take it all back.
Well, I'm speaking from a sort of point of exhaustion here. Didn't get to sleep till 3 o'clock last night and got up at about 6:30 this morning, and I think many of my colleagues did the same thing. And it's just a supreme team effort, I think. I think whenever anyone does this sort of thing, they have an idea what to expect. And I was expecting something like 100 species of mosses and liverworts, and I think over 130. So I was more than pleasantly surprised. Particularly this one here, which is one... it's new to County Fermanagh.
We're looking quite good. Hopeful. Good. Fingers crossed.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yay! Well, if you're watching the programme on Friday, you will know that Colin was actually in Coldbrook Estate, weren't you?
I sure was, and some of the information is coming back from there right now. It seems that they recorded most plant species out of the four sites.
Well done.
But it was close. I'm a little surprised about that. They found a new species of lichen to Fermanagh. They found St. George's mushroom, which is quite a find, another rarity. But also what they heard woodpeckers. And, you know, the woodpeckers sort of made their first Irish home in Wicklow. But they're spreading out all over the country now, so it's really good news to know that they've gone all the way up there. And what else? They found a Leisler's bat roost. Leisler's is Ireland's biggest bat.
But you can only count it as one bat.
Exactly.
You can't count all the bats.
You can't stand outside the roost going one, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Anyway, coming up after the break, we'll find out how the teams get on right here in Glendalough and Lochee Forest Park in County Roscommon. They definitely don't cheat. Welcome back to Glendalough here in the Wicklow Mountains National Park. Another beautiful evening, as I was saying earlier. Now, we're here for the results of BioBlitz 2013. Four teams at four locations across Ireland trying to record as many different wildlife species, plants and animals as they possibly can. Who will win? We'll find out very shortly. But right now, it's time to find out how the team did right here in the Wicklow Mountains National Park.
About BioBlitz is that the four sites have different qualities. Here in the Wicklow Mountains National Park, it's an extensive area of upland blanket bog and deciduous forestry. It's got a fantastic variety of habitats and it's got a very strong team as well.
We want to record as many ground-dwelling insects as possible. In order to do that, we're performing a method known as pitfall trapping. One of the groups of insects we're really interested in is called carbidae. And they're commonly known as ground beetles. Hopefully over the next 24 hours we'll catch loads in these cups and then we'll bring the samples back to the laboratory.
When we're surveying breeding birds of woodland like this, you seldom see the birds, but you can hear the birds singing, you hear them holding their territory. You hear the blackbird in the background serenading us. So that's our second one. We have a target of about 80 species, so we have two so far, so we better get moving.
What we're listening to there are bat social calls, those little squeaks. I'm going to turn up the bat detector to a different sound to try and get the calls as they come out, okay? So what a bat does is to find its way around in the dark, there we go, yeah, that's its hunting call.
Yes, immediately I can see a few moths in here. And I see three moths on this tray. We have another brown silver line. Also two similar shaped moths. This is a scarce prominent and a pebble prominent. So I said last night I was hoping to get 20 or 30 species. We didn't get anywhere near that. It was less than 10 species. But still, you know, 10 species is better than none.
spotted flycatcher or something.
Mm. Yeah. Just beyond us here. Chaffinch up here. What else have we? There's a wren just a bit further off, and a coltit. And a willow warbler just up at the top of the valley as well. There's some goats coming down to us too.
Okay, folks, we have a 1 o'clock tally from the four sites. The site that's leading at the moment is Coolbrook Estate, with 694 species. The next site, which is 80 species shy, is the Burren National Park. The third site is Loch Key at 478. They're doing extremely well. Wicklow is at 474.
Not that easy to catch, no. Not at all. They're great. Did everyone have a look? Everyone have a look?
What do you think? They're lovely.
We took a few samples from the rivers around the national park, and now we're sorting through them, and then later on we're going to put them under the microscope and see what species we've got.
Freshwater list, and there's some more mayflies and caddisflies.
Next year I would like to see a lot more stuff about bugs, because the bugs were a lot more interesting than the plants and all the butterflies. I like the bugs. Yeah.
So they did very well in Wicklow and Glendalough in the Wicklow Mountains National Park. I can tell you they had a spectacular dawn chorus, and I'm a dawn chorus fan, as you know, from the radio program. So it's still a good time to go out and hear the dawn chorus for the next couple of weeks, isn't it?
I reckon it is. And this area, I have to say, Wicklow, I sort of grew up not too far from here, and I still maintain that the Wicklow dawn chorus is the best dawn chorus
you
in
would.
The world.
Yeah, you would. And the people in Cork maintain they've got the best dawn chorus. But it's interesting, I was asking about the rules, and I wondered, did they have to see the birds? Because the one thing about the dawn chorus is you hear the birds, but you never see the birds. And I'm told, no, that because they are experts, it was good enough for them to hear the bird and identify it, and their word is taken. So didn't even need two people. Just one person was enough to hear the bird, and they noted it down. And then Wicklow also had the highest number of bryophytes of all the sites. So 163 different species. That's mosses and liverworts.
Sinead
so
was going to tell us that.
I was.
You,
I knew that. Yeah.
Well, too late. And the highest number of mammals for all four sites were found here. So there were deer, badger, fox. Everything.
And again, you didn't actually have to see the mammal, did you? Evidence of, you know,
scat.
The scat.
Yes. I learned this down in the burn, I'm telling you. And as well in Wicklow, they had 10 species of snail. They had the hairy snail and the garlic snail. And I actually didn't know this, but the garlic snail, if you rub it, actually smells like garlic, hence the name, I suppose. That's very interesting.
Okay, so three locations down, one to go. And it's Loch Key Forest Park in County Roscommon.
Loch Key is a great site for woodland, freshwater habitat, lakes and rivers, reed beds and bog. It's a really exciting place to work at and has been never really recorded for wildlife before. And so we're really excited about what we're going to find today. We have a fantastic team here at Loch Key. We've got some people doing a lot of the small things. So we're recording insects, lichens, mosses and liverworts. So we're really trying to get as many of the small things recorded, and I think that's going to be our edge over the other sites.
We're here to survey the fish species in the lakes around the Rockingham Estate area in Forest Park. So we're going to lower these nets this evening and leave them overnight, and we will come back in the morning and we will retrieve the nets, and hopefully we'll record the fish species that are present in the lake, particularly the bottom-dwelling species.
I'm Paul Whelan, and my area of interest is lichens, or as some people say, lichens. And the canopy walk is particularly interesting because it allows us to view a tree from the outside instead of having to climb up the tree on the inside and look out. Since yesterday at 5 o'clock, I have recorded about 75 species here, and hopefully over the rest of the day, probably double that number.
Here's one coming out. There it goes. This is a poplar hawk moth.
between us, we perhaps have recorded about just 12 species, whereas on a good night, if the temperatures were warm enough, we would have got maybe 40 or 50 species. But that's how it goes. You can't manage nature.
It's going to go. Yeah. We're in. Oh! Oh. Not yet.
Thanks very, very much, everybody, for coming out this morning. Last night, a few of us set out a few small mammal traps. The door is tripped, so we'll have a look and see. Now, fingers crossed there's something in it. Can you pass the trap to me very carefully? And then I'll break the trap open.
Oh!
So we've got quite a healthy wood mouse. We know that there's definitely wood mice here, so that's really good. We are minutes away from the final results being announced, and we're all very excited, a little bit on edge, and yeah, wondering what position we're in.
Have you got most of yours in?
Most of
it. Last minute mosses, insects, lichens, fungi, all being thrown into the online system, so hopefully that's made a difference.
Five, four, three, two, one.
A beautiful part of the world, Loch Kea, I have to say. If you haven't been, go and check it out. And they did really well, I'm told, with the lichen species up there. 103 lichen species. So the air must be very, very clean and clear and pure. And they had a great bat night as well. They got 7 bat species. I think we have 11 now. There used to be 9 now. I think it's 11. They got common pipistrill, soprano pipistrill, Daubentons, Leislers, Natterers, brown long-eared and whiskered bat, if you don't mind.
Good going. And, you know, the botanists were really pleased with themselves. They had set themselves a target of about 300 species, but they actually got 342.
And actually, their public turnout in Loch Kea was amazing as well, which is one of the good things about BioBlitz as well. They organise walks, public events. It allows people to get up close and personal with wildlife. So it's a wonderful event.
Absolutely. Well, as you know, this all started on Friday at 5 o'clock. 180 wildlife experts and recorders at 4 different locations. They had 24 hours to record as many different wildlife species as they possibly could in order to become BioBlitz champions for 2013. Let's find out who the champions are.
The time has come. I'm going to announce the winner of Ireland's BioBlitz 2013. And the winning site, with an incredible tally of 1,086 species, is Coolbrook Estate, County Fermanagh.
So congratulations to Coolbrook Estate and County Fermanagh, deserved winners of BioBlitz 2013, but well done to all 4 teams.
Absolutely, and you know, the final results were Wicklow 908 species, the Burren 947, Loch Kea 959, and Coolbrook Park 1086. But you know, all this information is going to be stored permanently in the National Biodiversity Centre in Waterford, as sort of a biological snapshot of our country at this moment in time.
Absolutely. And it's absolutely invaluable data as well, and it's a great reminder of the diversity of what's out there, our stunning wildlife and wild places. And hopefully this has encouraged you all to take a closer look, or better still, start recording wildlife for yourself.
Yes, get out there and enjoy it. A fantastic end to a month of RTE Goes Wild, online, on TV and on radio. Until we see you again, goodbye.